वेलकम बैक ऑल ऑफ यू टू आवर ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म दैट इज स्कूल दैट इज अवर स्कूल्स यूट्यूब चैनल। सो अगेन वी आर रेडी विद टुडेज वीडियो। दिस वीडियो इज फॉर क्लास 9th एंड द सब्जेक्ट इज साइंस एंड वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग द सेम चैप्टर दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 8 एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज मोशन। सो एज यू ऑल नो दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड द चैप्टर थियोरेटिकली एज वेल एज वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द क्वेश्चंस गिवन एज इन टेक्स्ट क्वेश्चंस एज वेल एज वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द एक्सरसाइज। सो टुडे वी विल रिकैप दैट चैप्टर अगेन सो दैट यू कैन कंप्लीट ऑल द क्वेश्चंस गिवन इन द चैप्टर इन योर रफ नोटबुक। सो वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द टर्म मोशन। मोशन, हाउ टू डिस्क्राइब द मोशन, हाउ टू डिफाइन दैट whether any object is in motion or not. So the proper definition is there: when an object is changing its position with respect to the surroundings, then the object is said to be in motion, or when the object is not changing its position with respect to the surrounding, then the object is said to be rest. With respect to the surrounding, what is that word? Means if I am moving, so how to assess my movement? So I am moving with respect to the board. I am here and after some time I am here, means I am far away from that position. So here the frame of reference is the board. So whether surrounding is the nearby any object. So these are the two definitions, one for motion and one for rest. When an object is changing its position with respect to the surrounding, then the object is said to be in motion, and when it is not changing its position with respect to the surrounding, then it is said to be at rest. At the same time, we have discussed the scalar quantities and the vector quantities. The scalar quantities are those quantities which are having only the magnitude. Magnitude means the numeric value, means the numbers are there only. So those are the scalar quantities. Vector quantities, whereas, are the quantities having the magnitude as well as the direction. As we have discussed the differences between speed and velocity, at the same time distance and displacement. So distance is the length of the actual path covered by an object from its initial position to final position. So I gave you the example at the time also, that when we are moving from one place to another, suppose from Bhopalgarh to Jodhpur by car or by bus, so we can take the different routes are there. So the distance will be the length of the road we are using to travel from Bhopalgarh to Jodhpur. But the displacement will be the aerial distance. Aerial distance means the shortest distance between Bhopalgarh and Jodhpur. So the definition of distance and displacement we can define like that: distance is the length of the actual path traced by an object from its initial position to the final position, whereas the displacement is the shortest path between initial point and final point. So at the same time, we can differentiate these two in the form of a scalar quantity and the vector quantity. Distance is a scalar quantity, whereas displacement is a vector quantity. Displacement is having a particular direction also. Direction will be mentioned there. At the same time, the distance cannot be negative, and displacement can be either positive, negative, or zero. One question was there when we were discussing the in-text questions: after covering some distance, can an object have zero displacement? Yes, if the object after covering distance comes to its initial position, then we can say that object has covered some distance and the displacement is zero. If the students are coming to the school from their home on the daily basis, so they are covering some distance, but after the school is over, they are going back to their home. So their displacement is zero from because they started from home and they get back to their home. Means they traveled some distance. As you are coming in the bus or you are coming in the van, so some distance you have covered, but the displacement is zero because from where you started in the morning, in the evening you reached at the same point. So this is a difference between distance and displacement. At the same time, the speed and velocity. Speed is the distance covered by an object per unit time, whereas the velocity is displacement per unit time. So the speed is the scalar quantity and velocity is the vector quantity. At the same time, again, the speed cannot be negative and velocity can be negative. The next terms we have discussed was the uniform motion and the non-uniform motion. Uniform motion, an object is under uniform motion in a fixed condition. That condition is that object should cover equal distance in a fixed interval of time, however small be the time interval. अब कोई भी टाइम इंटरवल हम टाइम इंटरवल में हम उसको डिवाइड कर दें दैट जर्नी, दे शुड कवर द सेम डिस्टेंस. इफ दे आर कवरिंग द सेम डिस्टेंस इन इक्वल इंटरवल्स ऑफ टाइम हाउ एवर स्मॉल बी द टाइम इंटरवल, देन वी कैन से द ऑब्जेक्ट इज अंडर यूनिफॉर्म मोशन. इफ दे आर द ऑब्जेक्ट इज नॉट कवरिंग द सेम डिस्टेंस और इक्वल डिस्टेंस इन दोज इंटरवल्स, देन वी कैन से दैट इज अंडर नॉन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन. At the same time, we have discussed the acceleration also. Acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. If the rate of change of velocity is negative, then it is also called as the retardation. When the speed is going down, it is decreasing, then we can say the object is under retardation. When the speed is, the velocity is increasing, then we can say the object is under acceleration. At the same time, we have also discussed the graph. For the uniform motion, we are supposed to have the same that the straight line inclined to the time axis. And we have also discussed two types of graphs, that is the distance time graph and the velocity time graph, or dt graph and vt graph. So too much difference is there between them. At the same time, we have also discussed three equations of motion. First equation was v is equals to u plus at, second was s is equals to ut plus half at square, and the third one was 2as is equals to v square minus u square, which we have used frequently to solve the numericals given in this chapter. So in the numericals as well, first of all we are supposed to read the numerical, afterwards we are supposed to note down the information given in the question, afterwards we are supposed to select the equations of motion. If suppose first equation of motion is v is equals to u plus at, so if out of these four terms, 1, 2, 3, 4, three terms are given, any three terms are given, then the fourth one we can calculate. So like this we are supposed to assess which equation we are supposed to use in which question. So we have discussed each and every term in this chapter, and we have discussed each and every question, whether it is in text or whether it is given in the back exercise. All the questions we have done, I hope that you have also understood. Now today's homework is that you are supposed to complete the chapter in your notebook, in your rough notebook. You are write each and every definition, and afterwards you are supposed to solve each and every question, that is whether it is in text or whether it is the exercise given at the end of the chapter. You are supposed to complete all the questions and all the theoretical part as well. Theoretical questions are not given in the book. So theoretical question means what is motion, when the object is said to be in motion, when the object is said to be at rest, what is uniform motion, what is non-uniform motion, what is velocity, what is speed, what is distance, what is displacement. All these things what we have discussed, you are supposed to note down in your rough notebook, and after completing this you are supposed to take the pic of that, and you are supposed to upload on the school's WhatsApp number, so that we should also maintain the record that how many students are completing the homework on the daily basis or correctly. So I hope that you will complete the homework today only, and you will take the pic of that, and you will upload on the school's WhatsApp number. Thank you very much.